Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you smart antenna with great clarity. Before I start with explanation, let me show you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first of all, I'll be explaining you structure of smart antenna. After that, I'll cover human analogy versus smart antenna analogy. After that, I'll explain you basic definition of smart antenna. After that, I'll explain you comparison in between switched beam system and smart antenna system. After that, I'll explain you how coverage area comparison is there in between smart antenna, switched beam system and conventional sectoring. At last, I'll be discussing about advantages and applications of smart antenna. So let us begin this session with first agenda. That is structure of smart antenna. Smart antenna structure is a combination of phased antenna array with DSP processor. In my last video, I have explained you phased antenna array. If you combine phased antenna array with DSP processor, then we can have smart antenna. Let me show you how. You can observe here we have multiple antenna elements, and these multiple antenna elements are connected with power amplifier, and these multiple antenna elements are also connected with phase shifter. Here, value of phase shift that has been defined by DSP processor. So along with phased antenna array, we are connecting DSP processor here, and that is resulting into smart antenna. Here, smart antenna means this antenna structure that will be radiating in desired direction only. For example, if I say here we have a user, let us say here we have a user over here, and this user is giving direction of arrival first. So here this user that will be giving signal to this smart antenna structure. So this signal that will come here to smart antenna, and it will identify direction of arrival. And based on direction of arrival, it will be radiating in desired direction only. Means radiation of this smart antenna structure that is happening in this direction only. So here, based on direction of arrival, smart antenna radiates in desired direction. That's why smart antenna is having minimum interference with its radiation. See, smart antenna technology, that is having a combination of phased antenna array along with DSP processor. Here, this DSP processor that will be defining value of phase shift over here. And based on value of phase shift, radiation by this antenna array will be there in desired direction. In phased antenna array, I have explained you, we have phased controller. But if you have DSP processor, then we have higher processing capabilities. Based on that, accurately, we can identify the direction of radiation. Right. So smart antenna that radiates in desired direction only, which is having minimum interference with its radiation. Now, I'll explain you human analogy versus smart antenna analogy. You can observe here, one can observe one human is listening two speakers. One is desired speaker and second one is unwanted speaker. So do you think this human can separate these two signals? But obviously no. But in smart antenna, if you observe here, we have desired speaker and here we have unwanted speaker. So based on DSP processor, it will define weightage of phase shift over here, and based on phase shift, it will be radiating in desired direction only. Means it can listen to this signal only, it can avoid this signal. The reason is in this direction, based on value of weightage, minimum radiation pattern will be there. So here, see this smart antenna technology, that is smart compared to human. Why? The reason is human cannot separate two signals, but smart antenna can. And it can separate two signals based on direction. So first of all, it will identify direction of arrival. Based on that, it will be focusing its radiation pattern in this direction only. Right. So that is how Smart antenna is smart compared to human. Now let me define definition of smart antenna. See, smart antenna, that is a combination of phased antenna array with DSP processor. Here you can observe we have desired user and here we have undesired user. So based on identification of direction of arrival, it will be steering beam towards desired user only, and that beam that is located towards this direction based on the value of phase shift over here and magnitude of phase shift, that is defined by DSP processor. So DSP processor is controlling value of phase shift over here. Based on that radiation pattern, that will be there towards desired direction. So first of all, it will identify direction of arrival from desired user, and based on direction of arrival, value of phase shift, that has been defined by DSP processor. So a smart antenna system combines multiple antenna elements with signal processing capabilities to automatically optimize the radiation and reception pattern in response to the signal environment. So here in signal environment, we have multiple users. Few users are desired users and few users may be undesired users. So based on direction of arrival, DSP processor will justify value of phase shift over here, and based on that, resultant radiation pattern will be focused towards desired users only, right? So that is what the basic definition which is there with smart antenna. Now I'll explain you comparison of switched beam system with smart antenna system. See, in switched beam system, we can switch the beam with well-defined location. Like as if I say here we have switched beam system antenna over here. So you can observe here we have one location. After that, if you want to switch the beam, then from here to here, second lobe is there. If user is coming somewhere over here, then this antenna system can switch to this direction, right? It can switch to this direction. So here different locations are there at which beam can be switched over here. But with switched beam system, there are few issues. Let me discuss that. Let us say user is coming somewhere over here, right? Here we have a user. If you have a user over here, then as per switched beam system, highest gain that will be happening in this direction. So here at this location, user will not be having highest gain, right? The reason is in switched beam system, well-defined locations are there with beam. So if user is coming in this vicinity, then beam will be getting switched with this lobe, right? And in cell sectoring, we can bisect this entire 360 degree into 120 degrees, right? And in 120 degree, we can have well-defined locations at where there can be switching of the beam, right? While if you talk about smart antenna, then here we have multiple elements. In switched beam system also we have multiple elements, but in smart antenna, multiple elements are connected with phase shifter, and value of phase shift is defined by DSP processor. So DSP processor will be defining weightage of this phase shift. Based on that, beam can be exactly switched towards desired speaker, right? Or you can say desired user. And if we have unwanted users, then this weightage is not giving any radiation towards unwanted users, right? So that is how things are different. In switched beam system, we have well-defined location of beam. At that location only, there can be switching of the beam. While in smart antenna system, we can steer the beam as per a direction of arrival, right? So with smart antenna technology, we have higher accuracy of beam, that one can say. If you observe another example of switch beam system, then you can observe here we have a user. So user is appearing in this direction where you don't have maximum gain. See, maximum gain is appearing over here with major lobe, right? Maximum gain is appearing over here with major lobe. And with this user, gain is somewhat lower than maximum gain. While in smart antenna, if you observe, see, as per direction of arrival, exact formation of beam is happening towards direction of arrival. So highest gain that is appearing in the direction of user, right? Now here if you observe, with interferer. See, as per the well-defined pattern, there cannot be any tuning of other lobes as well. So here interferers are there. So from interferers, sweet beam system will be receiving some sort of signals, right? But if you talk about smart antenna, then you see this is interferer. So towards the direction of interferer, there is null over here. Over here also another interferer is there. In that direction, we have a null. Means from interferer, you will be receiving minimum signals with smart antenna technology, right? Now I'll be discussing about how coverage area comparison is there. That is quite interesting. See, here in first diagram, I have low interference environment, and in second diagram, I have high interference environment. If you observe adaptive array means smart antenna. So in adaptive array, in low interference environment, higher area coverage is there, while with low coverage area is there with switch beam system, and with conventional sectoring, we have minimum area coverage. In high interference environment, you'll be observing smart antenna provides higher coverage, and compared to smart antenna, switch beam will be having lower coverage in higher interference, right? So if you talk about interference environment, in that smart antenna gives best performance, right? Now I'll be discussing about advantages and applications of smart antenna. See, smart antenna is having many advantages. As we know, it radiates in desired direction only, and that radiation happens based on direction of arrival, right? So it is having higher gain in that desired direction, and it is having interference rejection as well. Like you can observe here, I have shown here we have interferer, right? So with interferer, you see we have nulls over here. As we have null over here, this is also interferer. So as we have null over here, this smart antenna technology will be receiving minimum signals from the interferer, right? So smart antenna provides interference rejection as well. And increased system capacity is there with smart antenna. The reason is in desired direction only there will be radiation. And as if more users are there, in that case, smart antenna will be focusing towards users only. So here you will be having higher capacity of system with the use of smart antenna, right? If you talk about applications, there are many applications, right? See, in acoustic signal processing, we use smart antenna. In tracking radar, we use smart antenna. See, in tracking radar, we are delivered to track the target, where a target will be there in motion. So along with the motion of target, we need to steer the beam. With the use of smart antenna, what we do is we change the phase shift, and based on change in phase shift, beam steering will happen. And that beam steering, that has been controlled by DSP processor, where we can track the target with higher accuracy, right? See, in radio astronomy, we use smart antenna. In cellular system also, we use smart antenna. If you use smart antennas in cellular system, then you will be having higher capacity. The reason is cellular system will be focusing on users only. The reason is in general coverage area, you'll be observing many users are there. Along with the users, there will be interferer as well. If you can focus towards users, then you can have higher capacity, right? And smart antenna is also used in radio telescope. So there are many applications which is there with smart antenna. I hope now you are having fair enough idea about what is smart antenna and how it functions. Still, if anything that I'd like to share, just note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.